Here.
Alexander Woodland.
Here.
Next item, we have our first public presentation. Mr. Justice Council, please stand up for voting. Your name and address and any contact information. You can give 5 minutes. Next item on the agenda is the consent agenda.
Item A, motion to approve the minutes of the September 6, 2022 regular session.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass the consent agenda.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor of passing the consent agenda, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, same sign? All in favor, zero opposed. Next item is appointments.
We do have an appointment from the Board of Adjustment. A recommendation came from the planning, or from the Board of Adjustment at their last meeting on August 22nd. There were no objections at the September 6th meeting, so it's up for appointment tonight.
I would ask us to appoint Kent Offer to the Board of Adjustments. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All in favor, zero opposed. Next item on the agenda is the City Manager's Report.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. A couple of things to bring you up to speed on. Couple of street projects we're going to take care of at the end of the year. Chad just talked to Keller Construction today, and we'll be here this week to get started on the overlay projects that will be going on. And also the stormwater infrastructure has been replaced on Land and Drive, and replacing the street sections that year here in the coming weeks as well. So we'll have all that going. Also the service line warranties of America, our service line program that we partnered with them. They finally got all their information together. We're sending out the mailing list and all the promotional material here in the coming weeks. So we should see some information in the mail on that. And again, we just hope we'll get some phone calls here at City Hall, but that project will be kicking off here shortly. And then just to touch on, we've still got a lot of activity going on around the community. Was visiting with Greg there last week, and we've currently got 13 commercial projects currently underway. And then 10 new residential homes are currently undergoing. So again, a lot of construction, a lot of activity still going on during the year.
Good news.
That's all I got.
Do we have it on our city side what streets are going to be down so people?
I don't know if we posted that on our website or not, or on our Facebook page, the list of streets to be done, but that could be something that we can.
Just to give the neighbors a heads up that maybe on Harbin Road or.
And you're talking about the asphalt overlay.
Yeah, just the mid level kind of.
Keller Construction will go and they'll put door hangers on everybody's door the day before the construction actually starts.
But we can get that information out there too.
Yeah, they got to choose the ground school or.
Yep, we'll do.
Any questions, comments, concerns, city manager? Any other thing to add? Next on the agenda is unfinished business. First, we have a second and final reading of Bill 2022-31. Everybody hear me tonight? I'm trying to get the mic closer.
Bill 2022-31, an ordinance of the City of Cameron, Missouri, updating Section 5-55C, Service Charges of Division 2, Solid Waste Collection and Disposal of Article 3, Refuse of Chapter 5, Health and Sanitation of the City of Cameron Code.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-31.
So moved.
Discussion. We'll go to the
This is for solid waste.
Yes.
Anyone have heard of any further questions, comments? We now vote by way of roll call.
Dennis M. Clark.
Yes.
Becky Curtis.
Yes.
Julie Osmond.
Yes.
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Roy Estes.
Yes. Next item is the second final reading of Bill 2022-33.
Bill 2022-33, an ordinance approving the City of Cameron, Missouri budget of the ensuing fiscal year, October 1, 2022 to September 30, 2023.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-33.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
There have been no changes since first reading.
Becky Curtis.
Yes.
Julie Osmond.
Yes.
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Roy Estes.
Yes.
Dennis M. Clark.
Yes.
Thank you, Tom.
Carl's on here tonight.
That was a slow, painful process. All right, next item on the agenda is the second final reading of Bill 2022-34.
Bill 2022-34, an ordinance for the City of Cameron, Missouri, repealing the current electric rates and establishing new electric rates for consumers of the Cameron Municipal Utilities.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-34 on the second final reading.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
Okay, I have some. We're going to have five of these going on, and I really like for us to discuss exactly for sure, so that there is a clear understanding of what's going on here. We are getting an increase because of the cost of the materials that it takes for us to get our electrical costs, and the inventory takes forever to get, so therefore we're having to increase more of it, get more than we normally do because it takes more time. And the second, to keep our budget healthy in case something big happens, because the generator costs an awful lot. Are we in the process of trying to get another generator?
We've had talks about an additional substation out by the industrial park, should the additional demand be there for, you know, a larger or something like that. So that's something that we look at. And you're right, that is a very expensive endeavor that the city would take on if the need were to arrive. That is something that we were watching.
So this increasing our rates, not our original services?
Yeah, so the increase is a flat amount to every customer. And again, for the residential customer, it went up $4.05. So as opposed to being the minimum charge for electric being $7.95, it now is $12. No. Yes. Yes. We had a few rate increases in the past, but to do just an adjustment on our cost of service, it's been quite a while since we've done that.
And that's kind of what we're doing this time for all of them?
Yeah, it's to make sure that our rates more accurately reflect our costs. We do have a lot of fixed costs, and therefore there should be more emphasis on our costs providing the service, not how much you use.
Okay, so it's not on exactly how much we use, but more often.
This is just the bare minimum for us to be able to provide service to your house. It costs us X amount of dollars, and that's what we're charging. Now, how much you use, that's based on the rates that we have inside.
Okay,
that.
Okay.
That is not changing, it's just the additional.
Okay. I like that clarity, thank you.
And again, that is the same for the same that we've done for the water and sewer as well.
We do have a rate study coming out here.
Yeah, good practice is to do a rate study every 3 to 5 years, or when you see a change in your load or your demand. We've seen a change in our demand. Obviously, we had a change when we lost the prison. Now we're going to be getting the prison back. good time for us to reevaluate our rates and make sure that, again, make sure that they are reflective of our costs.
Anyone have anything else?
Julie Osmond.
Yes.
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Roy Estes.
Yes.
Dennis F. Clark.
Yes.
Becky Curtis.
Yes.
Next item on the agenda is the second final reading of Bill 2022-35.
Bill 2022-35, an ordinance for the City of Cameron, Missouri, repealing the current water rates and establishing new water rates for consumers of the Cameron Municipal Utilities.
Chair, we'll entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-35 on second final reading.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
Again, it's the same thing. We're simply adjusting the minimum cost of service for each customer.
Not the rate of use.
Correct.
Anyone else have any questions, comments?
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Roy Estes.
Yes.
Dennis M. Clark.
Yes.
Becky Curtis.
Yes.
Julie Osmond.
Yes.
Next item on the agenda is the second final reading of Bill 2022-36.
Bill 2022-36, an ordinance for the City of Cameron, Missouri, repealing the current sewer use rates and establishing new sewer use rates for consumers of the Cameron Municipal Utilities.
Chair, I want to take a motion to pass Bill 2022.
So moved.
Second.
Move and second. Discussion.
And again, this one is just like the electric and the water, with the addition that we did have to do a little bit of increase on the rate on this one to offset the cost of our $4.5 million upgrade necessary at our computer plant.
Right, which means this is the second bond we have on this sewer?
I believe there's just two. So I know there's at least two.
Right, so there's one for four or 5 years ago, which we're still servicing, and then we have this new one for this.
Correct.
So that's why.
And that is a lot better than the early reviews of, I think it's going to be like close to $15.
Correct.
Years ago when we initially talked about this. Excellent. And thank you guys. I know you're trying to keep up with the EPA mandates and everything else in the world.
It's not easy, but we do the best we can.
Any other questions, comments?
Roy Estes.
Yes.
Dennis M. Clark.
Yes.
Becky Curtis.
Yes.
Julie Osmond.
Yes.
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Next item on the agenda is the second final reading of Bill 2022-37.
Bill 2022-37, an ordinance authorizing the city manager of the City of Cameron, Missouri, to enter into a professional services agreement with Bartlett & West, Inc. for design of the Northland Drive project.
Chair, we entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-37 on a second final reading.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
I have a question to ask. Is this part of the engineering? I may be ahead of it, but will there be a turning lane on Northland Drive to go south? Will you create that?
I'm sure that there will be. Since
we'll make sure there is, because if we don't have more than two exits from the park, we're going to really need people out,
right.
You know, and we don't want to slow down everybody.
There's a turning lane there now on Northland Drive.
Well, it's not visual, but yeah.
Okay, but there is one.
But yeah, right, because people go to the drive.
You're right.
Yeah. So we just need to make it to see it.
Part of it's going to be narrowing that, wasn't it?
What's that? I've been hearing you.
Part of it was going to be, I heard you guys discussing that you were going to narrow it a little bit.
Right, but where Becky's talking about having a turning lane, that's would technically be on the state right away.
Okay.
Mary, you're correct. We talked about narrowing out the driving lane as you get closer towards the park. I know that's an extremely wide street as it is now. So that will be a little bit narrow, but we'll make sure we keep the turning lane.
Anything else?
Dennis M. Clark.
Yes.
Becky Curtis.
Yes.
Julie Osmond.
Yes.
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Roy Estes.
Yes. Next item on the agenda, the second final reading of Bill 2022-38.
Bill 2022-38, an ordinance authorizing the city manager of the city of Cameron, Missouri to enter into a professional services agreement with Bartlett and West, Inc. for design of the Harris Street project.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-38 on second final reading.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
Yeah, I have a couple, or at least one of them. Okay, so when we talked about this, we've already got a grant, okay? It didn't have to be done until, what, 2025?
July.
July of 2025. We've also kind of indicated that we might want to look at other architects, so maybe we ought to put this one on hold.
It's my understanding that these two have already been, there's some engineering already been done.
This one already has.
Seriously?
Okay, I didn't know that.
Is there anyone you were saying with me, because?
This one, Parrish, Northland Drive, and Godfrey, those have already been looked at.
And are those the only three right now?
Yes, correct.
So, can we make a recommendation that we not do that until we discuss what we're gonna do about our architect slash engineer?
Sure.
On any new projects, because I know the only one that wasn't done that we got on the agenda is our favorite gravel road in Cameron.
Right, but that's the engine.
Yeah, but they're not gonna use one there, anyway.
Okay. Anyone have any other questions, comments, concerns? Michelle?
Hold on, I'm still writing, maybe just a second.
So is that what we're gonna do, we're gonna put it on hold?
Well, we're gonna continue with these.
Before we bring up a new project.
Okay, okay.
What do you wanna do about that?
Becky Curtis.
Yes.
Julie Osmond.
Yes.
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Roy Estes.
Yes.
Dennis Clark.
Yes.
Next item on the agenda is new business. Yeah, the first reading of Bill 2022-39.
Bill 2022-39, an ordinance for the city of Cameron, Missouri, authorizing a change in zoning district classification from R2 to family residential to C2 general commercial for land located at 310 and 318 Little Brick, owned by Jason Wilkinson.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-39 on first reading.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
In your guys' packets, good evening, City Council. In your packets, you should have received information for the zoning change that went before planning and zoning September 12th. We did hold a public hearing for that. It was actually two co-applicants, Chris Wilkerson and Jason Wilkerson. This is the property for the village, I believe it's assisted living facility. One portion of the facility, which is 318, is already a branch of the facility. It's zone R2, so they're proposing to zone that to C2. And the other partial is a single family home, which is located on it, and they want to zone that to from R2 to C2 for future purposes.
And you said they already owned it, from what I understand.
Correct.
Okay.
Yes. We had, public participation at the public hearing. They just want to ask a couple questions. One of the stipulations was to, once a commercial property abuts a residential property, you have to screen it with a OPEC fence. And that was one of the concerns of the residents that came to the public hearing. So we're going to talk to the owners and let them know that is one part of the zoning requirements to install that fence. Other than that, it was after the approval from City Council, but the Planning and Zoning Commission to move it forward for recommendation.
always like to see businesses enlarge.
We've been busy.
Any questions? Comments?
Why do you think it's only been all that?
Thank you, Tim. Thank you. All in favor of passing Bill 2022-39 on first read? Please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, same sign? Five in favor, zero opposed. Chair will entertain a motion to suspend the rules and pass Bill 2022-39. Oh, okay. All right, cool. Next on the agenda is the reading of Bill 2022-40.
Bill 2022-40, an ordinance of the City of Cameron, Missouri, electing to have violations of municipal ordinances heard and determined by an associate circuit judge of the Circuit Court of Clinton County, Missouri, pursuant to section 479.040.1 of the revised Missouri statutes.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-40 on the first reading.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
This is the jumping off point to move the court. The very first thing we need to do is pass the ordinance with our intent to move the court and also increasing the court fees from $12 to $15, which is what the fee is for the county court costs. I did talk to Austin last week, and we tentatively have a go date of February 1st to do the switchover. I left that message with Judge Horseman that he was out of office that day. So it could be February 1st or it could be as late as April 1st, which would be 6 months. So, but the ordinance says within the 6 month time frame, limit unless we get an earlier go date.
So is that the reason you have to do a full instead of?
I asked for a full reading because I also attach the list of all of the things that we have to do, and it's quite large.
Yes, it is.
I don't want to delay it, so.
I appreciate that.
The quicker we can get started, the quicker we can get on down the road.
On step four, it talks about a $70 court automation fee. That is, it's not in our ordinance.
We only have that because we were already doing that.
So okay.
Some courts.
All in favor of passing Bill 2022-40 on the first reading, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, same sign? Five in favor, zero opposed. Chair will entertain a motion to suspend the rules and pass Bill 2022-40 on for a full reading.
So moved.
Second.
Jennifer, will you please?
Julie Osmonds.
Yes.
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Roy Estes.
Yes.
Dennis M. Clark.
Yes.
Becky Kurtz.
Yes.
Next item on the agenda is the full reading of Bill 2022-41.
Bill 2022-41, an ordinance authorizing the city manager of the City of Cameron, Clinton County, Missouri, to enter into a municipal agreement with the Missouri Highways Transportation Commission for the Walnut Street Overlay Project, J193267.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass Bill 2022-41 on the first reading.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
Basically, this is just the agreement with MoDOT to partner with them on the Melvin overlay of Walnut Street. They haven't given me an exact date, but I do know it's supposed to be in 2023 towards the spring, maybe first of summer. This is just basically an agreement for the City of Cameron. We're responsible for the parking lanes on Walnut between 2nd and 4th.
Yeah, I've been trying to figure out where those are. I know we talked about it.
Yeah. That is ours? Our,
yes.
Okay, that seems kind of weird, but okay.
They're just responsible for the driving lanes.
Okay. And we did a resolution a while back, but they wanted an ordinance, so it's coming back as an ordinance. And even though it's not going on until 2023, they need to get their paperwork in order, so we're asking for a full reading so we can get it back to them.
Is there any discussion for Grand or any other state roads here?
Not that I'm aware of. I know, I think the BB Highway, I believe, is going to be overlaid too.
How far on Grand? How far in Walnut are we talking?
I think they're going to do
all the way out to Walmart, and all the way over here to...
BB.
Just past BB.
Storage units of Dr. Carr?
I'm not sure if we're gonna go...
Well, I think it is past that too.
Well, it is, it's all, I mean, I know Lots Unlimited was not in the city limits, so I don't know whether it ends with Wesleyan, Court, and then there's also a building to the south of that.
Right.
And the next part of it was Lots Unlimited, so...
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Okay, I was wondering how far.
I know they're going to, work on the intersection at, Double E and 69. I think they're gonna continue going on north and come out there, so...
Excellent, good.
Yes, dude.
Yeah, very much.
Thank you, Ken. Anyone have any other questions, comments? All in favor of passing Bill 2022-41 on first reading, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, same sign. Five in favor, zero opposed. Chair will entertain a motion to suspend the rules and pass Bill 2022-41 for a full reading.
So moved.
Second.
Alexander Williams.
Yes.
Roy Elvis.
Yes.
Jennison Park.
Yes.
Becky Curtis.
Yes.
Julie Austin.
Yes.
Thank you, Dan. Next item on the agenda is Resolution 2022-42.
Resolution 2022-42, a resolution for the City of Cameron, Missouri to authorize the regrading of two job descriptions and to create two new job descriptions in the City of Cameron salary matrix.
Chair will entertain a motion to pass Resolution 2022-42.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
All right, so what we've done here is we have two job descriptions. One of them is my customer service accounting clerk. Now that we're not going to have a court clerk, my clerks are all going to be job rotating with each other. So two of those positions are graded at grade 3. The customer service is graded at grade 2. I'm going to be asking her to do the jobs of the grade 3 for the job rotating. The other one was when we reorganized the Parks and Reservoir Department, a lot of the parks tasks were removed from the Public Works Director's job description, and so we're looking to regrade that job from a grade 12 to a salary grade 11, since we created a new job, which obviously we are managing a lot of those responsibilities in that grade. And finally, job descriptions for a street and water distribution foreman. However, we have not had anyone in those positions for a while, and we did our update a couple of years ago with the new job descriptions and the new salary matrix because we didn't have anybody in those positions who didn't do those jobs at that time. So we have updated those jobs into the new matrix, and this is just placing them in the matrix so that we can possibly fill those in the future.
Will this have an immediate effect, or how big of an immediate effect will this have on budget that you just saw on the line?
Well, the customer service accounting clerk, that's the only one that actually has someone in that position right now. And it'll be a minimal change on as an option for one.
All in favor of passing Resolution 2022-42, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Five in favor, zero opposed. Next item on the agenda is our second public participation. If you wish to address the council, please come to the podium. Seeing none. Next item on the agenda is miscellaneous comments from the staff.
Can you go first?
Yep.
Okay. Just a quick note, we are dealing with a little bit of an issue at one of our substations with one of our circuits and one of the reclosers, and that's kind of what's been causing us the problems the last couple of weekends. aware of the situation. We're working on it. We're reaching out to see if we can find replacement parts and get those here in a reasonable amount of time. But again, we are working on that currently, and hopefully we can get that taken care of and kind of eliminate some of these headaches we've had in the last couple of weeks. And so we've also talked about ways that when we're looking at ways that we can kind of help get information out there as to when we have an outage. Now, obviously, the question we immediately get is, when will the power be back on? We can't answer that question, but at least we can let people know that, yes, we're aware of the situation and we'll take care of it. So we'll be looking for ways that we can improve that, and hopefully we can get some parts here in a reasonable time to take care of it. That's all I have.
Does it cost us extra money to use our fixed casters?
That was one thing that, like I said, we'll look at that and see what we can do and see what options we have.
Thanks. Just a reminder, this weekend, I don't know if Mark mentioned something earlier. He did. There's a citywide downtown, historic downtown cleanup scheduled for this Saturday at 9 a.m. We're going to be meeting in Corporal Park, so we're going to be looking for volunteers. So if you got some leaf bags, some leaf blowers, some weed kill, gas trimmers, electric trimmers, battery operated trimmers,
gloves,
rakes, just come out and help just to get our downtown looking good for these upcoming events. You know, one of the major ones is October 10th. October 15th, and then we got
I think March Fest is October 15th.
I say that.
You said October Fest.
Oh, I'm sorry. October Fest is October 15th. So, did I say it again?
March Fest
is October 15th.
And Fall Fest is
October the 9th. 8th. Yes, I'm sorry. I just get nervous when I'm around a lot.
And homecoming.
So that's it. So if you guys are free Saturday, come out and volunteer and help clean up the downtown.
Chief Asher? You done? Is the fire chief back here?
Yeah, I'm good.
Bragging. Ted?
Nothing.
Is there anybody? Council?
Nothing.
Michelle?
I got nothing.
Next item on the agenda is miscellaneous comments from the council. Julie?
I had the privilege of attending the MML conference at the beginning of the week, or the beginning of last week, and it was a pretty good conference. They had it down at the old Tantera, which is now Margaritaville. But anyway, they had lots of good sessions. I learned some things that I'd like to see implemented into the city, and I'll be returning next year. No?
I have nothing. Thank you. I have nothing.
Well, the Arts Festival was this last weekend, and a Marvel thing at the Fusion, 3rd Street Fusion, and it was a success, as I talked to Gina Reed. So I'm excited to see that more and more events are coming to our downtown. There was items sold, so the city did collect sales tax on that. And the next thing I want to say is I'm so thrilled to see all our roads being dealt with. I just really am so happy about that. Thank you, Pat.
Yes, I have. Thank you.
Go ahead.
All right. I wanted to thank everybody for chipping in. There's been multiple departments being brought in on a lot of the different programs that we're doing. New commercial business, residential stuff, streets. There's a lot going on in Cameron, and I know it's kind of taxing everybody. I'm glad Cameron's hopefully getting some rest tonight. It's been kind of a wild month. And just all the staff, we really do appreciate all you guys. It for me for right now. Next item on the agenda is executive session. Chair, I'm going to take a motion to move into executive session.
So moved.
Second.
Alex?
Yes.
Roy Elliott.